Yo, what's going on, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston here, and today I'm back for episode number 20 of my Boston Bruins Be a GM series here on NHL 16, and today we're back with the start of season number 3, so we hold a team meeting to start the year. That does not go over too well, but an interesting storyline as we approach the start of the regular season is Ryan Johansson is still a restricted free agent. He has not signed a contract with the Columbus Blue Jackets, nor anyone else. He has not even signed an offer sheet yet, so I took a look at his trade value. It was still pretty high. I always am looking for opportunities to collect assets like that. I thought maybe if Johansson had kind of been upset with his spot in Columbus, and maybe his trade value would have dwindled a little bit, that we could have striked and, you know, picked him up on the cheap, so to say. But it didn't appear that that was going to be the case. So we'll keep an eye on that as that progresses. I believe December 1st is the deadline for him to sign, or else he'll have to sit out the full season. So we'll see if that actually happens. I don't think I've ever seen that happen in an NHL game before, so that could be pretty interesting to see. But here we go. Take a look. It is opening night. Toronto versus Boston, a rematch of the first-round playoff series from last season. Tuukka Rask in net, and Antoine Bebeau getting just his second career start for the Toronto Maple Leafs. I'm not sure where James Reimer was. He must have been injured. So it is Bebeau in net for the Maple Leafs, and we are underway with the 2017-18 season for your Boston Bruins. And an early opportunity here, Marchand tried to get the shot off there. It was blocked. Bergeron retrieves the puck into the corner, gets it back to Marchand, and Marchand fires, but a good save by Bebeau. Tried to go far side there. Now Gardner brings it behind his own net to the boards, picked up by Bodker. One-timer, or tried to go one-timer to Krejci there with the cross crease, but that was stopped. Now here comes Brad Boyce for Toronto. David Rundblad on the ice. Our new third pairing of Rundblad and Tim Erickson getting some work there, and a Maple Leaf hits the iron right there. Now it's Connolly missing wide with the shot, but Hayes retrieves the puck, brings it back to the circle, fires and misses wide, but here we go. It's again Connolly bringing it to the top of the circle, now gives it to Rundblad, over to Kruger down by the circles. He tries to fire one far side, so plenty of opportunities early for Boston, definitely applying the pressure. Here is Toronto's first good chance, Luupola with a slap shot, but a good pad stop by Tuukka Rask. Now it's retrieved by Hedman, and he's going to bring it up the ice himself, showing off his capabilities as an offensive defenseman. Now he's going to try and bring it back to the point. He eventually gives it off to Pasternak, who's bringing it across. One-timer to Bergeron, scores, and Patrice Bergeron gets the Bruins on the board for the 2017-18 NHL season. It is the first goal scored by the Bruins this year, of course, and take a look at the replay. Pretty simple cross crease right here. Bergeron with the one-timer. He goes top shelf. Bebeau, a pretty low-ranked goaltender in this. I'm not sure what his overall is, but the team overall goaltending was a 78 entering this game, so did not look good. And then on the ensuing faceoff, Austin Matthews showing off the skill right here. It is year two of Austin Matthews, and he is only going to get better. Take a look at this play. Keeps the puck, controlling it around Gardner, and then is just going to snipe it short side past the glove of Bebeau. That was a really impressive goal by Austin Matthews, showing off his elite skill set right there and showing off why we picked him number 3 overall in the 2016 NHL draft. And Marchand gets decked right there by Dion Phaneuf. We'll see if there's any retaliation for that. Of course, Phaneuf recently traded. In fact, he got traded about, I don't know, 5 minutes before I did this commentary to the Ottawa Senators, and I'm not going to explain my thoughts. If you want my thoughts on that trade, you can go follow me on Twitter. The link is in the description. That's where I tend to give my real sports opinions on things. But anyway, here's Pasternak bringing it across. Tried to go forehand, backhand there, but a good stop by Bebeau. Good job by the defenseman to sort of cut off the angle there from Pasternak. Now, opportunity on Rask, but he makes the stop, and that would end off the first period. So we have a 2-goal lead at the end of one, and I apologize for all my sniffling in this video. I am slightly sick, slightly under the weather, whatever you want to say. And very stuffed up, actually. So probably going to be sniffling throughout the video. But there we go. Another look at Matthews' snipe right there. I freaking love that goal. That was such an impressive play. Now Bergeron with the puck past the circles. Tries to carry it in. Looks like he got stick lifted there. Brings it back across. And look at Matthews with the hand-eye coordination. Batting that one out of the air. Trying to get that one on net. And does. But it was stopped by Bebeau. And then here we go. We're on the power play here. But take a look at the pressure being applied by Toronto. It's Corrado to Komarov. Back to the point. Now Corrado, Komarov, one-timer. And that one was stopped by Rasko. Actually, it was Toronto doing a lot of the damage while we were on the power play there. But then it's Austin Matthews getting his second goal of the game. This one, pretty weak goal let up by Antoine Bebeau. You can see Bergeron just kind of carrying it in front. Gives it off to Matthews, who sort of, I don't know if he put that through the five hole or what. It was really not a good goal allowed by Bebeau. That one probably falls squarely on the goaltender. Here we go now, midway through the second period. It's Jimmy Hayes showing off the speed here, bringing it up. Tries to go backhand, forehand, backhand, and actually beat the goalie there, but the puck fell off his stick. Retrieves it, gets one more opportunity, but misses bounces wide with the shot, and then Connolly's actually going to get hooked here. But take a look at the pressure being applied by the fourth line. This is one of the best things about this team. We have four lines we can roll out at any time, and we can really get good pressure with either one of them, or any one of them, I should say. Now here we go on the power play. It's Krejci giving it off to Griffith. Back to Krejci, looking for the right shot here. Eventually just try to dip that, or dump that one down low to Bodker, but he couldn't hang on. Now he retrieves it, fires it far side. That one is stopped by Bobo. Riley retrieves it behind the net. Now it is Fanouf, and he eventually dumps it out of there. Now it's David Runblad carrying it to the Toronto zone. Feeds it across to Kruger, but he couldn't quite get the angle. The pass was just a little too far in front of Kruger. That was really the only angle you could make that pass at, though. So I guess you can credit that as a good defensive play by Toronto. And then there's an opportunity by Grabner. Tries to fire far side, but another good stop by Rask. He had a pretty nice game, although I'd say we definitely limited the chances that Toronto had all night long. Here is some impressive puck handling by Kevin Hayes right now, and he's trying to get a shot off there. Ends up getting or misses wide as he got hit. So Spooner retrieves it behind the net, now bringing it in front past the circles, dumps it down to Pasternak, fires off the post right there. Spooner retrieves it now, tries to go cross crease to Pasternak, and he scores. David Pasternak, a really impressive shift right there from the third line, as a lot of zone time and really doing work from all three forwards, and that's what I really like about this third line. It's a very, very deep third line. Spooner and Pasternak, you could arguably play in the top six. Hayes is only an 83 overall, but, you know, in real life, I think he's probably a little bit better than that, or at least could be a little bit better than that by the time you reach 2017. So, either way, we are at the end of two. Boston's got a solid 4-0 lead right now. We are dominating play, really making a statement game that this year is not going to be like the last, of course. We had a very good regular season last year and fell apart in the playoffs, so not too much of a statement. We're making about as much of a statement as you can make in the regular season at this point. I mean, we are really coming out and dominating one of our biggest competitors in the division. Of course, they do have their backup goaltender in there. That is one caveat, but I would say we've had some nice plays that probably would have beaten Reimer or whoever they would have had back there in net, especially a couple of the cross creases and maybe the Matthews snipe. I don't know. You could attribute that one to Bobo possibly just not being that high of an overall. There's a nice opportunity from Kevin Hayes. That gets stopped. Now here's Komarov giving it up to Sean Matthias. He actually gets by the defender here. That was a really bad defensive play on my part. I was kind of fooling around at this point in the game. Only 6 minutes left, still up 4 goals. So Matthias gets the Maple Leafs on the board. You can see that was Hedman that I controlled and tried to go for the big hit with. Hedman has really been, I've played a couple games with this team now, and Hedman has really been laying the iron, so to say, as he is dished out some big hits. But there we go, end of regulation. Boston picks up the 4-1 victory to open the 2017-18 season. The Bruins are 1-0-0, and that is a wrap here from the TD Garden. So as you can see, the Bruins celebrating on the ice, their first win of the regular season. Toronto not leaving quite as jubilantly as they had the last time they were in this arena when they walked off the ice, or skated off the ice, I guess you could say, with a Game 7 overtime victory. There's another look at the Matthews snipe. God, that was such a good goal. That was really nice. But anyway, take a look at the stats. We outshot them 33-15, and time on attack was almost a 6-1 ratio there, so really dominated them throughout the game. You can see the three stars, Bergeron, Matthews, and Pasternak. So that is going to do it. Hope you guys did enjoy. Thanks for watching, and I'm out. Peace.